Hey, what's up, guys? This is Team Hard Life Captain Albert Sartuce, and this is part two of trip number two for Alligator Gar. I'm actually here with Sean Mendez of Team Boat Up Fishing. He has taken me to one of his spots, and like I said, I'm going to try to keep it as hidden as possible, you know, because a lot of times these spots get shared and they don't get taken care of. And with these guys finding these new spots and or you know, putting in the grunt work to find them, I definitely want to show respect by keeping it as hidden as possible. So that's where we're at on this. However, we are here alligator gar fishing during a tournament for Gar Addicts that was held here locally in South Texas, where you can fish pretty much anywhere you want it. You just have to go live to their Facebook page and enter your catches that way. So here we go. We already got baits out. We are actually using tilapia for bait, and I am still testing out this different way of fishing using J-hooks and bridle them to the bait, so that way I can ensure that even though I catch a big gar, that I wasn't gonna have the hooks be too deep into them to where we couldn't get them out safely. Because as you know, last year we did a lot of gar fishing and we caught some monsters out there, and it was just a chance we took with the way we were fishing. So I definitely want to improve my game and my knowledge on them. So here we go from the ground up testing, and this is also part of our Teach a Man to Fish series as we try out new things. And we'll show you everything as it happens, whether, you know, we catch or we don't catch or we miss fish, because it is all part of the trials of learning a different way of fishing. So stay tuned for this, guys.
Got a lot of stress on my mind. It's a nice day to go. Yeah, I got a line. I'm a caller, the whole team.
One of the things that we did do was before the tournament started, we went and caught fresh bait. I also did have one leftover carp in the freezer from several months ago when they were brought into the shop. So I brought that along with the tilapia that we were going to be using for bait. We were fishing this point right here where we learned that the farther that we could get away from the shore enabled us to have better hookups. This was after the first several hours of sitting there, and immediately, as you notice, we pretty much started getting pickups, but nothing really committed to the baits. But they did show us that they were interested in the flavor that we were putting out there. Now, with this Teach a Man to Fish series, I am still putting out both videos. One, showing where we do catch, and two, the amount of time it takes in between catches. So between putting some full-length videos out, to a lot of people really enjoy the sights and sounds of just being out there, you know. So I'm trying to keep it as real as possible. However, we still have those that like to get to the meat and potatoes, so both videos will still be coming out on this. So we'll be doing that, and also too, giving those who love the calming sounds of just being out there without having all the commotion, all the talking, all the everything else, just sights and sounds of what it would have been like to sit out there for your enjoyment. So stay tuned for this. We will keep rocking it, and I got more info later on in the video. So as y'all know, earlier I took off to the truck to go get a few extra things because, one, I found out that we were allowed to use extra rods if we paid for them. The limit was 4 rods per person at $10 a rod, $10 entry. So I was still playing the numbers game here on whether I was going to add the extra rods for more action or leave it at the 2 that we started with and just go from there. However, making the long walk back to the truck and coming back with the gear is a good one. So we'll see what happens between now and then. Yeah, I can't really run in pants and shit. Then I brought the 14-foot rod too. Yeah. You off or no? Hold on, come here. I'll go live, but really just in case. And actually, my DeWalt, I got that plug where we need the DeWalt battery from the truck. I thought it could charge more, otherwise I would have brought that big charger and it could do two phones at one time, like 20 times over. Huh? What? No, it's only one plug. I thought it could do more, otherwise I would have brought it right now that I was... We'll see how much it charges up that phone. I brought those chocolate ones, the ones I got, the cookies. Over 200 yards. Got the alligator gar was there. Something started moving, I jumped real quick. You know what's in the lead right now? On your other rod?
Okay.
Yep, you got those two. You have to be on that other rod. You can't pull in a third unless you're pre-paid.
You can do it fast enough?
Already there? I have no idea where I'm at, actually. Woo! Now that's definitely a nice one, contender right there. Beautiful, bro. Good shot. Let's see. I'm trying to control two cameras at once, guys. Yeah, definitely get that one measured out. Perfect hook set right there, too. Have to go get it. I'm keeping the fish or is it okay for me to go? Sorry, I've got it.
Oh, you're
here, hold on. I'll back up. I'll go get the board real quick. You got needle nose?
I'm gonna put it in the light.
Got it? Let me go get it real quick. I'll just back up like this so I keep you in camera the whole time. Yeah, that's a beautiful, beautiful alligator gar right there, guys. Sorry, trying to control two cameras, one on a tripod, not on a tripod. Turn it sideways. There you go.
Number 41, guys,
go ahead, turn it.
There
you go. With Mr. Albert Sertuce,
hard life.
Ooh. Dude, look at that.
Oh,
I almost put my hand on that.
Oh,
you
left that thing
here? Yeah, well, we can definitely clean up a little bit. Now we got to get it back in the water, right?
Yes.
You got a needle nose or no?
You don't have any?
In my bag. You got it? Yep, got it all, brother. Yeah. Yeah, we got a smaller alligator gar that we're gonna take home because it. Put it around there and just pull it. Go around the head like that. And then
right past the gills and then cinch down. There you go. And that way you can drag him.
Oh shit,
Yep. Come on. There you go. Got to turn on the light over here. Swimming off. Good job, bro. Awesome. Yep. Good safe release right there, guys. Hooks were removed. Sean Boat Up Fishing. Beautiful.